Hi guys, in this video I am going to discuss what program to find largest and second largest element from an array. So I enter into the size of array. So I have given 7. So total numbers of elements are enter 7. So first is 19, 7, 54, 34, 21, 7, 54. So enter 90 is the largest element in the array and 54 is the second largest element in the array. So the output come first largest number equal to 19 and second largest number equal to 15. So let's see the code. Next, I'm going to discuss what the try and method of this program. So if you debug the code, control comes to main method. Hereafter that coincides. So right here, I've created a scanner class object sc by using new keyword scanner system.in. Hereafter, I've taken integer array type variable 8 over r and I've given the size 55. So maximum you can enter 55 elements into the array. So first variable is 8 over r. And the size is 55. And hereafter, I have taken four integer variables. First is n, next I, and hereafter max 1. And max 2. So hereafter control comes to this point, system class.alt.print method. So whatever we told code that display into the output screen, enter the size of array, so that display into the output screen. Here n equal to sc.nextint method I used. So first whatever the value that set to a string value, so that I'm using sc. So sc is the object of a scanner class, so that call int nextint method. So that convert all the string value into integers and that go to n. So I am going to enter n value 5. Hereafter system closed the out.print method. So this all display into the output screen. Hereafter for loop, I value start from 0 again. And here check the condition 0 less than n value 5. Condition is true, that coincides. So let's enter 8 over r 0% new element. So enter 8 over r 0 sc.nextint. So nextint that convert all string value into integer and that store into 8 over r 0. So this is here I'm going to create array. So this is a 0 index. Here 1, here 2, here 3, here 4. So 0 point I'm going to enter 91. Hereafter loop continue. So I is 1 now. Check the condition 1 less than 5. Condition is 2. So let's enter 8 over 1% new element. So enter, I'm going to enter 6. Now I increase. So I is 2 now. Check the condition 2 less than n value 5, condition is true. So let's enter 8 over r 2% element. So right here I'm going to enter 55. Now I increase, so I is 3 now. Check the condition 3 less than 5, condition is true. So let's go inside. So here I'm going to enter 8 over 3% element 9. Now hereafter I increase, so I is now. I is 4. Check the condition 4 less than 5, condition is true, so that coincides. So let's enter 8 over 4% new element. So at here I'm going to enter 21, and hereafter I increase, so I is 5 now. Check the condition 5 less than 5, condition is not true, not coincide. Hereafter max 1 equal to max 2 equal to int dot mean value. So minimum value of int is in Java program. So this all. So for checking, let's go to this point. So at I have taken integer variable max and max equal to int dot mean value. So this return a minimum value of integer and that is stored into max. So let's run the file. So this is the minimum value of integer. So at here, int dot mean, so this value go to max 2 and max 1. So at here, minus 2, 1, 4, 7, 4, 7, 4, 8, 3, 6, 4, 8. And on max 2 value, the same, minus 2, 1, 4, 7, 4, 8, 3, 6, 4, 8. So hereafter control comes to this point. For I value start from 0, check the condition 0 less than n value 5. Condition is to that coincides. So at it or 0% greater than max 1. So 0% 91 or greater than max 1 value, this all. So obviously 91 greater than any minus value. So condition is true. So that coincides. So at a max 1 value go to max 2. So this value go to max 2. So no any changes. And it or 0% value go to max 1. So this point the value come 91. Now hereafter if condition is true, so that not go to else part. Hereafter that curve increase the value of I. So I is now 1, check the condition 1 less than 5, condition is true, so that coincides. So at it or 1% greater than max 1. So 1% is 6 and maximum value in 91. So 6 greater than 91, condition is not true. So this if condition is false, so that go to else if part. So at here, 8 or 1% greater than max 2. So 1% is or 6 or greater than max 2. So 6 or greater than any minus value, condition is true. So at here, 8 over or I, so I value is 1. So 8 or 1% value go to max 2. So 6 comes to this point. And hereafter loop continue. So loop is now hereafter I is 2. Check the condition 2 less than 5. Condition is 2. That coincides. So at 8 or 2% greater than max 1. So 2% is 55. 55 greater than 91. So this condition is not true. So not coincide. If part here that execute else if part. So 8 or 2% greater than max 2. So 2% is 55. And 55 greater than 6. Condition is true. So 8 over all. 2% value go to max 2. So 2% is 55. 55 comes to max 2. And hereafter loop continue. So loop is now this time I value is 3. Check the condition 3 less than 5. Condition is 2. That coincides. So 8 or 3% greater than max 1. So 3% is 9. 9 greater than max 1 value 91. So this condition is false. So I not execute. Hereafter else if part 8 or 3% greater than max 2. So 3% is 9. So 9 greater than 55, so this condition also false. So that not coincide. Hereafter I increase. So I is now 4. Check the condition 4 less than 5, condition is 2. So that coincides. So 8 over 4% greater than max 1. So 4% is 21 and max 1 value 91. So 21 greater than 91. So this condition is not true. And here 8 over 2. I value is 4. So 8 over 4% greater than max 2. So 4% is 21 and max 2 value 55. So 21 greater than 55, condition is false. So that not coincide. Hereafter I is 5. Check the condition 5 less than 5, condition is true or not true. So that not coincide. Hereafter control comes to this point. So it is system class dot out dot print LM method. So this all display into the output screen and the value of max 1. So maximum value is 91. So 91 display. Hereafter system class dot out dot print. So this all display into the output screen and the value of max 2. So max 2 value is 55. So this on display. And hereafter that outflow main method. So here I enter n value 5. So you can try to enter n value any number. So if you enter n value 8, so you have to enter 8 elements into the array and do the same try and method then. So definitely you will get the expected output. So this is the try and method of this program. So I hope guys this video is helpful for you. So one more point, if this is the code I already written, if I am going to execute, so at here if I am going to enter 8, so let's enter 8 elements into the array: 12, 89, 76, 56, 43, 89, 54, 67. So at here, First largest element is 89 and second largest element is 89. So 89 is the 2 times, this is the highest elements into the array, so 2 times, that's why this is a displaying 89s in both. So suppose if I'm going to enter this time elements of 4, so not going to enter highest value of any number, so 12, 90 and here after 67, 43. So at here, see this time I enter the array 4 and enter the element, so 12 and here after 90. So 90 is the highest or largest element in the array and 67 is the second largest element in the array. So this is the output we get. So now in this video, it's over. So thanks for watching. I hope guys this video is helpful for you. So now, thank you. See you next video.